Well, there were still some flaws with this chapter. At least they did it a lot better than the anime. Much better. Let me explain. What's going on, boys and girls? SSJ Quinn here, and today I will be reviewing Dragon Ball Super Chapter 31. Now, I'm sorry if reviews aren't kind of your video. I know they're not the most interesting videos ever, but I do like doing them every now and then when I get the time to do one, and especially with the Dragon Ball Super manga. Now, if you are new to these reviews, because my subscribers have been slowly going up, so this could be your first time ever watching one if you actually want to watch it. Basically, the way I do it is that I show you a bunch of pictures from the manga, and I review the chapter and tell you guys what happened first, and then at the end of the video, I will go over and tell you guys all my thoughts of it. Again, this one isn't too interesting because it wasn't like the greatest chapter ever, but I'll explain why that was in a second. But also, I did review the anime episode of this, so if you want to see my review of that, it will be in the description below. Anyways, let's get started, and yeah, here we go. So the chapter starts off with Hercule again taking credit for beating Cell, and they have like a cool little movie looking thing here of Hercule fighting Cell, and the producer also asks, hey, how did all the people come back to life after fighting Cell? And Hercule just claims it's just because he's a superhero and it can do the impossible. So he also took credit for what Shenron did as well. Then we have Krillin and his family hanging out at his house, and it's kind of cool to see. If you look down the right corner here, they actually got quite the nice little house. And Goku's basically stopping by. He has a small snack, even though he already just stuffed himself, and he still eats a crap ton of food, and he tells him about the tournament. And just like in the anime, he lies and tells him it's just for fun. And Krillin, just for no reason, says that he's in. He mentions this earlier that he's out of shape, and it seems like he just wants to get in to better himself. I really, really like how they did this in the anime, you know? Krillin's not being no baby and stuff like that. He's, you know, he wants to better himself, and that kind of reminds me of the old Krillin from Dragon Ball, you know? I'm getting a little sick and tired, and I know Dragon Ball Z did it as well but at the very end, but, you know, seeing all the characters that we know and love just get lazy and not want to fight anymore. And so far in this chapter, Krillin just joined for no reason. He just wants to better himself, so props to that. But Android 18, on the other hand, is different, and she doesn't want to join unless there is a pay. Now, whatever, right? I mean, she was never super into fighting anyways. And Goku, of course, makes up a lie and says that each person wins 10 million Zenny who participates, and that definitely changes Android 18's mind. And he also tells Android 18 that Bulma will watch Marin as well, so they're all set and ready to go. Now, one thing that I just wondered, you know, if Krillin and Android 18 are really struggling for money that much, I wonder why, you know, Bulma doesn't help them out. I mean, she has so much money, it's insane. That's just a little idea there that I had. But anyways, moving on. And anyways, so he asks Android 18 where Android 17 is, and she doesn't know. And they have no way of finding him because they can't sense his key. He doesn't put off any. But they get the good idea to go ahead and ask Dende because he is the god of the earth. I like how they brought Dende back by doing this because it makes him more useful instead of just a useless character. It seems like the God of Earth is useless. Now, I think it's kind of shitty to think that because you gotta remember that all of the characters in Dragon Ball are so strong that it makes the God of Earth look, you know, crappy. Well, in reality, Dende is much stronger than the average human. Plus, in real life, if we had somebody who could heal somebody with a touch, they'd definitely be considered a god. Just thought I'd point that out. But yeah, I like how they brought Dende back. Just like in the anime, Dende can move the look off around the world as he pleases, which is something we didn't know he could do. I don't know why, but I think this is a really cool idea. And my question is, where did the power pole go? Because in this picture here, it looks like it's about to fall down to Earth. And on Goku's ride on the look off, he wonders why 17 turned into a good guy after coming back out of Cell. And Dende explains that when Krillin removed the bomb inside of him with the wish from the Dragon Balls, it made him regain some of his humanity, so it could be Krillin's fault why Android 17 is actually a good guy right now. I mean, he wasn't as evil as the ones from the future, but still, he was still a little on the evil side, so I guess that makes sense, though. It's cool to know why he actually became good. Dende also says that he's very strong, and he's actually gotten stronger, and he says that if he was an enemy, he'd be actually quite worried about it. And they also fly over Oob's village, and we finally get to see Oob. And Dende says that Goku should teach him how to raise his power because he's a reincarnation of Majin Buu. Of course, he's not evil. And Goku, believe it or not, actually says that it's not his style and he's not really that interested in teaching him. I don't know if that changes or not, but yeah, right now it seems like it's Dende's idea to teach him. So yeah, the ending of Dragon Ball seemed like Goku wanted to do it himself. This could also be because he doesn't know that he's going to be so strong yet.
Then Goku runs into the evil poachers on the island, and he thinks one of them is Android 17, and he puts on this mask because he doesn't know what it is. He asks the fellow that he took it off if it makes him stronger, because he thought he was Android 17 at first. Then 17 comes and lays a beat down on the poachers, and he thinks Goku is a poacher because he's wearing the mask, and he forces Goku to go Super Saiyan 2 when he attacks him.
And then he even forces Goku to go Super Saiyan 3, which I find a little over the top, and I'll explain that later. And then Android 17 charges a giant energy ball, which, as you can see here, freaks out Goku quite a bit. And then Goku talks to 17 and says, "Yo, calm down, it's just me." 17 explains that he saw Goku while inside Cell, and he also heard his voice while he was inside as well, so that's how he recognizes him. And apparently the Hunter people are after the Minotaurus as well, which they didn't make a whole episode on, which I'm really, really happy to see, because in the anime they made a huge filler episode about it. 17 states that he owes Krillin one for taking the bomb out of him, and he kind of wants to meet him because of that reason. So, Android 17, he wasn't going to do the tournament, which I find kind of weird because even though everything was going to get destroyed, he didn't want to do it. But then he finds out he can get a bunch of money with a wish from the Super Dragon Balls if they win, and he also wants to meet Krillin and give him his thanks. So those are the two reasons he wants to join the tournament. And I find it a little bit weird how he wants to win a boat to take his family on a trip, but at the same time, he won't fight in the tournament to save his family from impending doom. Kind of weird, eh? And it turns out Boo is asleep for the tournament, just like in the anime, which sucks because I really wanted to see Boo fight. And Piccolo is going to train Gohan, and he wants Senshu's to fight with him and train because he doesn't think that they can win without Gohan, and this here is the end of the chapter.
Now for this overall chapter, I'm going to have to give it a 6 out of 10. I'm pretty sure on my anime review I gave the episode a way too high of a rating. Just let me explain here. What I liked and didn't like about this chapter. I really like how it started off. I really liked how Goku went to Dende and stuff and got him to show him to Android 17. That was just cool to bring Dende and Popo back in the story, even if just for a little bit. You know, make Dende a little bit more useful, a bit more of a useful god of Earth, shall we say. So that was pretty cool. What I didn't like was the fact that Goku still had to go Super Saiyan 3 to fight Android 17. Let me explain. So, back in the Cell Saga, Goku could have beaten Android 17 as a Super Saiyan when he was fighting Cell. That makes sense, right? So, the way I see it is that, you know, Super Saiyan's just multipliers, so if Goku could have beat him as a Super Saiyan then, and he can't beat him as a Super Saiyan now, that means over all these years that, you know, they haven't met, Android 17 has gotten stronger than Goku has. Not saying that Android 17 is stronger than Goku is, but what I'm saying is that the fact that Goku is stronger as a Super Saiyan, and now he is not, yeah, Android 17 has just, like, it just progressed more than Goku has. Because, again, Super Saiyan is just multipliers. Now, if Goku went Super Saiyan God or Super Saiyan Blue, probably could have kicked his ass. But the fact that he had to turn Super Saiyan 3 against him, while back in the past he was stronger as a Super Saiyan, means Android 17 got a crazy strong power boost. And I don't understand how he got that much stronger just, you know, being on an island protecting animals, unless there's some kind of reason that his Android makeup slash build makes him stronger over time, even stronger than what Goku has progressing. The way I see it, if Android 17 could somehow turn Super Saiyan 1 or 2, he would absolutely destroy Goku. You know what I mean? Do you get what I'm saying there? Long story short, I don't think Android 17 should be anywhere near as strong as Super Saiyan 3 Goku, but they did a much better job than they did in the anime. In the anime, Goku went Super Saiyan Blue and was evenly matched, which was absolutely ridiculous. So still in the manga, it's a little over the top, but not as bad as it was in the anime. So at least good job that you fixed it a little bit there. I'm sure whoever made this chapter saw the complaints and was all like, "Oh yeah, we can't let that happen again." But still, I liked how they brought back Super Saiyan 2 and Super Saiyan 3, but I think Goku should have been able to just do it in a Super Saiyan form, shouldn't have to advance any further than that, especially since his base got stronger after getting Super Saiyan God, but that's just my opinion. So, moving on, I still think it's weird how Android 17 wants to buy a boat for his family with a wish from the Super Dragon Balls. You would think with the powers that he had, if he really wanted a boat so bad that he was going to the only wish in the world that he could have, he was going to use it on a boat, you would think that he would actually use the wish on his, like, you know, something just better, and he would just somehow use his powers on Earth to get enough money to get a boat. Because I'm sure he could, being able to fly and do all that stuff, but I don't know. That's just an opinion. Not really a big deal, just something I thought I would bring out. I also hate how Boo is still asleep. I really would like to see him in the tournament, but I know they can't change the story that much that Frieza's not in the tournament in the manga and also have Boo in it, so I understand where they're coming from there. And I liked a lot how they didn't have, like, crap tons of filler, you know what I mean? Because back in the episode, they just had, like, way too much of it, like a whole episode of filler of all this. They just kind of skipped it all over, 17 join, and that's it. So that's good. I'm happy about that. But anyways, overall, I'd say 6 out of 10 chapter. It was pretty good. It was, they could have did a couple more things. I think they could have did changed a little bit more in the animation. Had Goku only go Super Saiyan 1, not Super Saiyan 3 fighting 17, but that's just me. And yeah, that's basically it. I really like what they did. I think they improved over to anime. The anime did have a very, very good fight scene and very, very good animation and very good art. Again, if you want to see that, it's in the description below. But yes, that is all I got for today for this review, guys. I would like to see down below what you guys saw this chapter. Please go ahead and tell me what you thought. And I'm going to have another interesting video coming out today. And I'm going to keep trying to upload as much as I can. I've just been very, very busy working as a paramedic, working over 60 hours a week. And you know, Christmas time, family comes first, right? So sorry with the long time before an upload. That's just how it is. Just busy. And I'm trying to do as best I can. Anyways, thank you very much for watching, guys. Thank you for all the support. Even though I haven't uploaded for a while, my sub count is slowly but surely going up. So that's friggin' awesome. Thank you very much again, guys. Have a fantastic day. SSJ Quinny out of here.